everyone, it's Jen, and I'm here today to do a really short video to talk about some of my new coloring supplies that I've gotten. I've gotten a few things over the last few months, not a whole heck of a lot compared to what I used to get, but some things that I've gotten that I'm really happy with, so I thought I'd go ahead and just show you guys. And of course, as always, my coloring assistant is here, so just bear that in mind. I have my tea, so cheers. And let's get started. So in here I have a few stencils that I have either picked up in my travels at craft stores or ordered from Amazon. Excuse me. And I think I got this folder at Staples. I want to say that's where I got that. So this is one of the stencils that I've used on a picture recently, on a mermaid picture from the 100% mermaid book that I have. I used the little suns, and I think I used the stars, and I think I got this at Hobby Lobby. I'm pretty sure. I think that's the sticker from Hobby Lobby, so I got that one. This is one that I've had for a long time. Frank gave to me. This is just all different color circles. He had it from his architecture days, so that is nothing new. And then, just in case you're wondering what this is one of those, I know you really can't see it, but because it's clear, but this is one of those Japanese writing tablet things. This is a thicker one, if you can see the thickness on this one. I don't use this one too much because it's smaller. I actually use the blue one that I have a whole lot more, but I just decided to keep that in the folder so that I wouldn't lose it. And then I have these. I think I bought this on Amazon. Can you even see it? You can see it that way. Okay, so this is just a bunch of clouds that I use in different pictures. Clouds are kind of a thing that we can always use, so I really wanted to have a stencil with clouds, so I got that on Amazon. This I got at Dick Blick when it was on clearance. This is just a whole bunch of pretty stars. Another thing that I got at Blick on clearance, which is the snowflakes, and I used this for one of my Misfits pictures for Christmas in July, so that came in handy. I got this one at Hobby Lobby, I think. I'm pretty sure that's where I got this one. Yeah, Hobby Lobby. So this is just a bunch of leaves and stuff, and it's got some like acorns and leaves and just like different kind of foliage for the fall season. I thought it could come in handy for fall coloring. This one I got on Amazon. This is just butterflies. And then this one I think I also got on Amazon. This is just hearts and stars and circles. So you can use this in a variety of different things. Like if you wanted to make some sort of scaly type thing on a person, like a mermaid or a character or whatever, you can use these little different sizes and stuff. So all kind of useful. I want to collect some more stencils, but I'm kind of choosy with the ones that I'm choosing and like just trying to get things that I would actually really use and need. So that is my current stencil collection. The next things that I got are these. Let me try to zoom in a little bit here. So these are, I've been mentioning these in my videos recently. These are the Copic Spica, or Copic At You Spica pens. It says on it, twinkling like stars, At You Spica. This is set A. Mona, one of my BFFs, she's so special to me and such a good friend. I was going through a hard time and one day, these just arrived for me. She just wanted to do something so nice and kind out of the goodness of her heart, and she sent me these because she knows I'm a glitter addict and she loves them, so she thought I would love them too. And she's right, I absolutely love them so much. I've been using them, actually let me show you. I've been using them in a new coloring book that I have. So some of you guys may have seen this if you saw my coloring book haul. This is the Mythographic Animals coloring book, and I love this because I've been using all glitter pens on it, and then I've been coloring the character in pencils. So I think you can probably see all the glitter on this, and I've been using a variety of different glitter pens, and these Copic Spica things, I've been using these along with the Color It gel pens and the Stardust jelly roll pens. So here is the first one that I did in this, and I just finished this Froggy last night, and then I have one more. Do I have one more? I think I do. I know I'm working. Oh yes, I did the Otter. That was the other one that I did. I've done this all within the last week, and I've enjoyed this so much. And I know a lot of people have appreciated the idea and are going to be doing it too. So I think we may have a color along at the Reading with Pugs Facebook group in this book with all glitters and then coloring the characters with pencils. A lot of people are into the idea and have been purchasing the book. They kind of felt like me, like they didn't want to color a little tiny stuff until they saw my idea and then they were into it. So I think we're going to have a color along and it's going to be a lot of fun. But this is a lot of fun to do. This is the one that I'm working on right now. These are with the Color It gel pens, and I highly recommend those. They are such a nice pen, and they come, I think it's, is it 48 pens, and then it comes with a full set of refills. Actually, let me show you. I got these quite a while ago, and I hardly used them until recently. Now I'm using them every day. And it comes in this case, this beautiful glittery case, if that's not enough. And then you get all the gel pens. They come in it, and then you get a full set of refills for them. So how can you go wrong? They work amazing. I love them. I actually have the colors swatched. I know, who am I? I don't usually swatch stuff, but I had nothing to do yesterday, so I decided to swatch them. So here they are. I know you can't really see all the glitter in them. There, you kind of can. But they are so pretty. They work really well, and I'm really happy with them. So those are those, and then I swatched the, that's my son's drawing, I swatched the Copic Spicas. So this is set A. I just want to show you the glitteriness of these. Are those not amazing? Oh, love, love, love. So those are the Copic Spica At You pens, gel pens, whatever. So that's those. That's set A. Sorry, let me just move all this stuff. So that's this set, and then I decided to order set B for myself because, you know, we have to have everything. So this is set B. So they're really kind of pastel-y and just as beautiful. Look at that black. Isn't that amazing, the pitch black? I love that. Sorry, I hit the camera. And then there's a clear one in there. So yeah, these are the, this is the set B, and they're a little bit expensive, but they're beautiful and I love them so much. So I'm really happy to have those and been enjoying using those very much. So that is that. Another thing that I finally broke down and bought was the Derwent really long pencil sharpener. That is not the title of it, but it makes a really long point. And I had the, now I can't think of it. I can't, the X-Acto. Yes, the X-Acto. I had the X-Acto. It was just gonna be one second. Okay, my apologies. I had the X-Acto sharpener, and the only thing you could use with it was the Prismacolors. And I didn't like it in the fact that, first of all, it was breaking a lot of my Prismacolor pencils. That was the first thing. The second thing was it has a suction thing on the bottom of it. So, although I'm spilling stuff everywhere, you would have to suction it down to like some kind of non-porous surface and then like be able to use the crank. But the thing constantly would release from the surface. So you'd be like in the middle of sharpening and the thing would come up and then you couldn't sharpen anymore. And I really wanted to get something that would make really sharp points because I really appreciated the points that those would make, that that sharpener would make on the Prismacolors. And I've been hemming and hawing over this one because it is expensive. It was about $28 on Amazon. And I had it in my cart and I never actually purchased it, and I just kept thinking about it and thinking about it, and then the other day it went down to $19. It was under $20 and I was like, that's it, I'm pulling the trigger. So I got it and I've been using it and I love it. It is so nice. It's really easy to use. You just feed the pencil through here. You don't even have to attach it to the table. I just put my hand here and I sharpen it and the pencils come out great. You have the little bin here that catches your shavings as you see if you're using it. I got this on Amazon and I really love it. I haven't even been using my M&R sharpener now since I've got this. I'm sure that I will use it again because I do love my M&R sharpener, but this is really nice and I really, really like it. Okay, the next thing I got is finally I was able to get another one of these three slotted cases from the UK, from Amazon UK. I have the Mickey Mouse one. You guys have seen it before. I found this because of Sammy, Color and Chat with Sammy. She has two of these and I fell in love with them. And when they became available on Amazon, I stupidly only ordered one. And then they became unavailable that they would not ship them to the U.S. And then finally, I kept checking, and this past week, I finally got one. So this took only 4 days to come from Amazon UK to me, and it got here so fast, and it came like by courier. It didn't even come by mail. It came by courier. It was so good, so worth it, and I'm so happy with it. I haven't really filled it up yet because I'm still deciding what I want to do with my pencils, because that's another thing that I got. Frank actually bought me the 40 set of the Luminance pencils. So right now these are in this case, and I like the case because it's nice and it keeps them safe, but most likely I won't be keeping them in the case forever. I probably will buy an actual pencil case for them. But since I just have the 40 set, I've just been keeping them in here and using them like this because this is not too bulky to keep like on the couch, which is where I primarily color, or at the table. And then we went to Dick Blick this past weekend and I picked up 6 more, because if you buy 6, this is more than 6, but I had a few. If you buy 6 or more, they're cheaper to purchase it that way. They become like $4 and change a pencil rather than almost 6. So every time I go, I'm just going to buy 6 until I have the whole entire set. So this is what I have right now, and I just decided to put them in here. I was keeping them in the Mickey Mouse pencil case, but now they're just like separated out here, so I'm fine with that for now. But I've really enjoyed using these. They're really nice pencils. I've gotten a lot of questions lately. Would I choose these or the Polychromos or the Holbeins? And they're all different pencils. They all work differently. Luminance are the most expensive pencil, without a doubt. I know you might say the Holbeins are, but you get 150 set for, what is it? Like, I think the Holbeins are down to about 270 right now on Amazon. But you can't get any free, I mean, you can't get any open stock on Holbeins. But I believe somebody told me they are going to start selling them open stock on Amazon or somewhere online. And I think you might even be able to get them now. I'm not sure. I have 2 sets of Holbeins, so I'm not in the market to buy any single stock right now. But I'm sure someone in the comments will tell us if you can purchase them open stock. People know stuff, so I'm sure somebody will tell us. These you can buy open stock, so that's nice, but there is only a 76 set, and like I said, if you do purchase them individually like I'm doing, it's going to actually cost more money to buy the 76 than it is to buy the whole set, so you have to keep that in mind too. If you're only buying a single pencil here and there, they're $5 a pencil, so there's that. The Polychromos are probably, out of all of these 3, they are definitely the cheapest of the pencils, but they are beautiful. You get 120 set of those for a lot less than the Luminance cost, so it's really what you want. You know, what is in your heart? What does your heart desire? They all 3 pencils color beautifully. If I had a pick out of all of them, what would I pick? I'd probably pick my Holbeins, because you guys know I just really love those pencils. But a very, very close second would be my Polychromos, because those have always been my favorite until I got the Holbeins. So these are just kind of like a luxury. They're something I didn't have, something I wanted to try, and something that, you know, we could afford to get. So that's the thing. If you're limited on your budget, I wouldn't go for these, because they are, like I said, they are beautiful colors and they color lovely, but they're the most expensive and there's not a lot of colors. I mean, here it's only 40, but there's only 76. So I hope that helps. And the people that have been asking me about these since I got these, a lot of people have been asking me about it, sending me messages, writing on the Facebook, writing in my comments. So I just wanted to, you know, explain that a little bit. This would probably be, out of the 3 that people have asked me about, this would be like the least one that I would choose. So that's totally up to you though. Like I said, it's all in what your heart desires. If you really want these and you feel like your heart's not going to be happy unless you get them and you choose something else for another reason, but you still are wanting these, then you're better off just getting these. So my father always said, if you want it, get it, you know, as long as you can afford it. That's the thing with coloring stuff. It's nice to be able to stand here and do a coloring supply haul for you guys and show you my things, but you know, I know that not everybody can afford everything. This hobby shouldn't become a money drain. It should
be
fun. It should be about coloring, about using your stuff. And in my last video, I talked about Operation Use Your Coloring Supplies. And that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to use my coloring supplies on my things so I can enjoy them. We kind of get stuck in a rut and kind of use the same things or the cheaper things actually so that they're easier to replace. But you're putting money into buying these wonderful things. You should be enjoying them and loving them and using them. So a concentration shouldn't be on getting everything. It should be on using everything. At least that's my philosophy. It should be on using all of your stuff and loving it and enjoying it. And with that mindset, I've just been really happy diving into all my stuff and using it all because it's important to me. So, like I said, these things are a luxury. I have another pencil set to show you guys. This was one that I showed you a while ago. Let me zoom it out a little bit. I have the full set of the Faber-Castell Bold Fabers. I really love these pencils. They are so nice. They color really nice. They're a little bit of a harder pencil. The colors are bright and beautiful, and they're really nice to color with. In this case, I also have, this is the rest of the set of the Gold Fabers. This is the Derwent Drawing Set. I've had these for quite a while. I've used them a lot in my Emily Olberg book. Not too long ago, I never even told you guys, Frank actually purchased me the Derwent, what are these called? The Graphitints. Yeah, so these are really nice pencils. I've not used them on any book, but I swatched them all out, both coloring with them and with water, because you can use these with the water, and they're really beautiful. So let me show you what the swatch looks like for those. So this is the swatch for the Graphitints. So these are all your colors. The ones on the left are just colored, and then obviously the other ones are used with water so that you can see what they look like. They're really nice, and I just need to get an opportunity to use them in my coloring books. So here are the grays, and that's what they look like. And then I think I have a swatch in here of the, yeah, of the drawing pencils. I really like the Derwent drawing pencils. They are such pretty colors. They're very muted and very like earth tony, but they're really, really nice to use and fun. And you can also get those open stock at Blick. I don't think you can get the Graphitints open stock, so that could be a problem eventually if you start to run out of them. But yeah, so that is the story. And then these are the Kohinoor Tritones. I've had those for quite some time. I should actually swatch those too, because, you know, why not? I have a swatch book, might as well do it. But again, these things are all a luxury to have. You don't need everything you see in order to enjoy the hobby. It's just, I work for a living, my husband works for a living, so we can afford these things, but it's not like you absolutely need them. It's just, these are things that bring me joy, so if I want them, I get them. And that's the thing, you don't need everything. So I think I've made that point perfectly clear now. Now I'm rambling. So I have shown you everything that I have gotten recently. Like I said, not a whole heck of a lot. These were actually acquired over some months. The pencil case and the pencil sharpener came in the past week, but these pencils were bought months ago. The Luminance came a few weeks ago, and the other Copic speakers were a gift from Mona from a few weeks ago. So I'm really happy with all of these things, and I don't know if anybody else has any of these things. Oh, you know, the other thing I wanted to mention about the sharpener, which I totally got off course, is with this sharpener, you could only use the Prismas. Not with this sharpener, with the X-Acto sharpener, you could only use the Prismas. With this one, you can use your Derwent Color Softs, because I tried it. You can use your Luminance, because I tried it. And you can use your Polychromos and your Prismas on it. So with that in mind, I mean, I can use my Pablos with it. I can use, I'm having a brain fart right now. I can use my Super Colors with it, obviously. And it's a great sharpener. It's really, really, I'm so happy with it. I didn't think I would be this happy with it, but I really am. And it also comes, if you see this little hole here, it comes with a little clamp so that you can clamp it onto the table. And if you wanted to use it like that, you don't even need to. I actually sit on the couch and just use this, which is fantastic. And it makes a really long point. Let me actually demonstrate for you. I don't actually use the white in this set too much because it's not like my favorite. So let's go ahead and let me move this so that I can get it on a sturdy surface. So you just pinch the little ears together like this and you put it in as far as you can. And then, like I said, I just hold it here and you give it a couple of go arounds and you see if it's where you want. If not, then you put it back in. But look at that point. I'm just going to stop it there. Look at that point. Isn't that nice? And you can make it even, well, let's go ahead and do it. You can make it even longer if you should like. And this is so nice because I've been using these pencils in my, look at that. Oh boy. That is so nice. And if you go light-handed, maybe with these you could actually go a little bit more heavy-handed, but if you go light-handed with your Prismacolors at this, you won't even break up. I mean, if you go heavy enough, of course, the Prismas are going to break, but that's just the nature of those pencils. But if you go with like your Polychromos or these ones or a harder pencil, like the Luminance or whatever, you're not going to break them. You can keep this tip for quite some time, which is really nice. And I've been working in my Zemla Schnova. I never know how to say that book. It's so embarrassing. I've been working in this book. That is what my son did. Very lovely. So I've been working in this book and I'm using my Polychromos in this because I haven't used them in so long and I feel so guilty. I miss them. So we are reconnecting, me and the Polychromos, and I've been using these in here. And now that I have the sharpener, I've been using them and they are like a dream. They are so sharp and you get in such tiny little spots and I love it. So that is what I'm working on with my pencils. Now you know what I'm working on with my gel pens, and I would love to know what you are working on or if you got any new supplies. Sorry I've been rambly, but I'm just really excited about my things and excited to share these things with you. So like I said, if you got any new things or you have anything that you have comments on or thoughts about these things, leave it below and I will see you in the next video, and thank you for watching.